Shall I tell you a story about Peter and his friends and a wolf? Once upon a time, well, this is a musical story, and like all stories, it has characters. And in our story, each character is represented by an instrument in our orchestra. First, the bird. The bird is represented by the flute. And the duck, the quacking of the oboe. And the cat by the soft clarinet. And grandfather, very serious and strict, by the bassoon. And the wolf by three horns. Now Peter, the hero of our story, is played by all the strings in the orchestra. And the hunters, played by the woodwinds and the strings. And the guns of the hunter by the loud drums. Once upon a time, early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went for a walk in the meadow. On a branch of a big tree sat Peter's friend, a little birdie. "Everything is quiet," chirped the bird merrily. Yes, everything was very quiet. Even the pond was so still, the water was smooth as glass. Just then, a chubby little duck came waddling along. She was glad that Peter had not closed the gate and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Flew down to the grass and settled right next to the duck and shrugged his shoulders. What kind of a bird are you if you can't fly? To this the duck replied, what kind of a bird are you if you can't swim? And dived into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming in the pond and the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's eye. He noticed the cat. The cat said to herself, that bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him. Silently, she crept towards him on her velvet paws. Look out, shouted Peter. The bird quickly flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat. From the middle of the pond, the cat crawled around the tree and thought, is it really worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away. Just then, Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone into the meadow. The meadow is a dangerous place, he said. What if a wolf should come out of the forest? What would you do then? Grandfather's words. Boys like Peter are not afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter by the hand, locked the gate, and led him home. Excitement, she jumped out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer and nearer and nearer until he caught her. Suddenly, he got her and with one gulp, swallowed her. And this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch of a tree. The bird on another branch. Not too close to the cat. And the wolf was walking round and round the tree, looking up at them with greedy eyes. In the meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the locked gate, watching all that was going on. He ran home and got a strong rope and climbed up to the high stone wall. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. He grabbed hold of the branch and carefully climbed onto the tree. Peter whispered to the bird, "Fly down and circle round the wolf's head, only take care that he doesn't catch you." The bird flew down around and around the wolf's head, almost touching it with his wings, while the wolf snapped angrily at him from this side and that. Did worry that wolf, and oh, how the wolf wanted to catch that bird, but the bird was too clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter had made a lasso and began to carefully let it down. Lower, and lower, and lower, and he caught the wolf by the tail and pulled it tight with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. Thank you. end of the rope to the tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope pull tighter around his tail. Just then, some hunters came out of the woods. Following the wolf's trail, shooting as they went. Peter, sitting in the tree, cried out, "Don't shoot! The birdie and I have already caught the wolf. Just help us take him to the zoo." And so along they went, just imagine that triumphant procession. Up front was Peter in the lead. After him, the hunters came leading the gray wolf. Came Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather shook his head discontentedly. "Well, if Peter hadn't caught the wolf, what then, ? High above them flew the little bird, chirping merrily. Look what brave fellows we are, Peter and I. Look what we've caught. And if you listen very carefully, you can hear the duck quacking inside the wolf because, in his haste, he had swallowed her alive.